the population, only 20% is local people. Only 20% of Emiratis. So we call the locals Emiratis. You have now 80% of the population coming in from more than 200 countries. 200 countries represented here, living and working together in perfect harmony. We'll talk a little bit more about that. I just want to point out some land. To the left, the Hard Rock Cafe, which was the only building here. They're now relocating it. Of course, it doesn't fit in with the beautiful marina, so they've pulled it down. They're going to relocate the Hard Rock Cafe. Again, to the left of us, we can see some big names, some international companies. You will see eyes for them to travel around. So you find more and more people are coming here to Dubai, especially with the global recession that hit. People are finding that they have opportunities here, which they might not find in their countries. Pink, Burj. Yes, that is the very iconic landmark for Dubai. It's what the Eiffel Tower is to Paris, the Burj Al Arab to Dubai. We can see the color, and it will be changing color, so it goes multicolor through the night. That's the 7-star hotel. Ultimately, any decisions that are made has to get his final stamp of approval. But this is only if it's anything affecting the country.
How you want to spend your time.
Phenomenal development here. You will see when we visit the museum tomorrow. It's not official that it's the tallest building yet because they haven't opened it. Burj Dubai side of Dubai, which is known as the modern part of Dubai because the later construction happened along this way and all the new projects are on this side as well. So we're now on the Burj Dubai side. We've crossed over the creek using the Maktoum Bridge. So we've got 5 crossings. We've got the Maktoum 13C where it says Port Rashid. Can you spot that on your map? So we're pretty much going towards right now, coming up on the right. This is something that you would have seen at the Samaya Hotel as well, with the golf ball on the top, just to the right. Etisalat. Etisalat means to call. They were here in the region for about 20 years, had the monopoly for 20 years, and 2 years ago we had a competitor called Du. So now we have 2 companies providing telecommunications. The satellite dish is in the actual golf ball. Now, if you went,
would go to the top of the minaret and announce the call to prayer, which is the adhan, you've heard this. Now he doesn't need to go to the top anymore, they've got sound systems, but traditionally he would have to go to the top. So you'll always find the minaret, either one or more, it doesn't matter. Then you'll also see the dome. Again, it could be one, it could be many. We have the mosque in Abu Dhabi, which has 82 domes, so it doesn't matter, it's just decorative purposes.
Dirhams, and you can pay it over 20 years, no interest. The people who did the mines, very, very expensive. Dubai, very expensive city. The most expensive things for us who live here as expats is your housing, medicalized housing, medical completely free of charge, and education completely of your country. So we don't get these benefits. We pay for housing, we pay for education, and they give us a health world. And we catamaran. Very beautiful at night. So the shape very unusual at night. They have a laser light show reflecting on the hotel, and that's what caused
the Burj Al Arab Hotel, the highest building in the world, on the Arabian Sea. We're going there tonight for dinner. The thing jutting out there is a helipad landing area. That's where Roger Federer played a game of tennis last year. The beach on the Arabian Sea. Super yacht.
The stipulations are cover up to the wrist, up to the ankles. First to go into the market or any place with a little bit of a shorter shorts than what I'm wearing today and spaghetti top, you're going to have a lot of men looking at you. And you'll understand later when we go, because there's a lot of different people there.
We're going to the big mall. It's a big mall where the indoor ski slope is. Sculptures.
Thank you.
Hunera, they've actually
ski slope in Dubai.
Whether they're going to complete the project, we have no idea. At this stage, it's in the very beginning stages, but we have also
a very, very Rashid Al Maktoum. Here we see is now officially the Crown Prince of Dubai. So she's got, yes, she's got Western blood in her. We've never seen her. This area is going to be developed. It's going to be known as the Business Bay area, where you have all your multinational companies. Many, many companies, of course, have their head, meaning Dubai Tower. So the design, very, very beautiful. The inspiration was from a desert flower. If you look at the base of the building, it looks like a petal coming out of the bud. Kidmore, Merrill and Owen. The estimated height is going to be over 818 meters. They're on the last sphere right now. They're just doing the top. The building is officially not open yet. It will open. Tallest in the world, the two that looks like the Toblerone chocolate. The taller one at 355 meters is the commercial tower, and the shorter one at 305 meters is the Emirates Hotel. Of course, they made it to look like the Toblerone chocolate. If you went inside the hotel, you will find Toblerone. Again, coming up on the right side, we have the beige building. Just to the long time, it was the only building and the tallest building on the street. So this is one of the oldest. It's designed, it's basically capturing all the activity of the water. The blue triangular one next to it, that's the Dubai Chamber of Commerce. And your hotel is literally behind this, where the Etisalat ball is, where the golf ball is, that's where you guys are. So remember I told you, if you wanted to take a stroll in the evening, it's literally about a 7-minute walk to get to the creek. So this is the Dubai Creek, which you see. These brown boats, which are called the dhow boats, these are the wooden boats which do the lunch and dinner cruises. It's a 2-hour cruise along the waterway. Very beautiful. Most of them have lovely colored lights, so it's almost like an Arabian fairy tale gliding down the waterway. The two Rolex buildings which we see here, these were previously known as the Twin Towers. So just to the right again, the two Rolex buildings. These were known previously as a city south of Iran called Bastik. This is a heritage site which was built in the 1800s by the Iranians. This is where they used to live, the wealthy merchants. This is where they lived. So it was very much a whole community living here. The entire structure made out of coral stone and lime. Now here you will see. Now, when we think in the 1800s, 50 degree temperatures, they needed to find a solution. So this is why they designed these wind towers, what it actually...
We'll be right back.
by water taxi across the bay, the markets. So the water taxis in Dubai.
it's hot. Dubai is never cold. It's gonna be hot.
It's gonna cost to be our move. Hotel. Lamborghini.
the Burj Al Arab from outside. We just had dinner there tonight. This is the Medina Hotel, which has got the wind towers on top. This is the Medina Hotel. Right on the beach in Dubai.
Always put your hand in and pick them up, can't you?
You allowed to fish here?
Rather than getting the buggy.
You sure you don't want me to see?
Now there's the bridge there, there's all the girls up on the
bridge. That looks like the Rialto bridge.
Yeah!
Jump!
La salamia.
Who's that?
No Kagamara's here, is there?
Come on, jump!
I found them. You left us here.
You've just got to jump down.
We come
to you. Oh my goodness.
Oh yeah, right here.
Over this side. We'll come back up.
Oh my goodness.
Just stay.
It's on this side, this cage.
What are you doing?
Okay, you jump off and stop the boat.
You're joking. Where are we going to go? Can't get off here.
Yes, you can.
You want to keep going?
Some huge, big Century Metro shopping mall on the way home from the our dinner.
There's the market we went to, it's just over there.
underneath of the kandura, they would normally have boxer shorts. I've been asked this question many times. Normally, they will have boxer shorts. Now, the headscarf is called the gutra. This was used when they lived in the desert to protect them from the heat of the desert. White, sometimes red and white, and sometimes black and white. I did tell you yesterday, in this country, it doesn't matter. It's become somewhat of a fashion statement where you can see lovely embroidery, Swarovski crystals. Tomorrow, 6 o'clock in the morning, going to the airport, most definitely I will be in my abaya. For us, it's a garment of convenience. If you're rushing off
somewhere... There's the Dubai Hotel, the new one's not quite finished yet. Tallest building in the world.
Break it with water and a date. So whatever you've lost in nutrients for the day, you would replenish yourself immediately. And here it's not just boring dates. You can see, for example, the lady take a picnic basket and
over.
Largest shopping mall in the world with 1,200 stores, and the Dubai Mall, of course, now it just officially opened in November of last year. 12 million square feet out of 5.9 being dedicated to retail space. You've got souks inside, you've got the lovely gold souk inside.
The Algeria Mall, so the Dubai Mall.
160 food and beverage outlets if you don't want to shop them.
This is a huge big aquarium inside the Jumari Mall. So you can actually go in and dive with the fish and the sharks if you want.
Thank you.
shops. This is the gold souk, or the gold markets.
They can know and we can know which Arabs are from different parts by their dress and the way they speak.
What's that?
That's the Wafi Mall. We spoke yesterday that a lot of the men were starting to marry outside women as well, because they say the Emirati lady is very expensive. We cheap, because if we marry, we basically need a house. And then the government introduced the marriage fund as startup money. This is just to encourage them to marry within the communities.
Okay. What's that back there, sir? And elsewhere there?
Yeah, we government with massive injections of money into the economy.
Even here, also in Dubai.
Shortcut. These are the cars that we're going on the dune tour on. Run, rabbit, run. Oh, okay.
No, no, that is what is a compressor. But when you're on the top.
best vehicles for doing this sort of thing.
When you invite everyone out of yours?
No, I wouldn't be game, I'd scratch it.
Yeah.
And one of the guys from our church, he wanted me, he was desperate to get me out of doing one of the four-wheel drive courses. Said he wasn't religious. Sand dunes. You've got to try and get there.
Wow,
the
next one.
Look at yourself. offside stand just gives Roy a front, though.
Wow, these are professional camel riders.
Robbie, put your legs down low.
Yeah. Oh, goodness.
On and lean back.
This is the fun part.
Now. Wow.
Now. Oh, there's so much. Robbie, you've done that so much.
How was that?
I got two each time, so I got
Oh, that was a right and a half.
Ah, goodness, that's good. Where is she? She's having a good time. How was it?
That was fantastic. Let's go again.
Ah, goodness, here we go. Hello, Len Cheryl.
I won't let go and say hello.
Oh, girl, Cheryl. Oh, I'm so proud of you.
Shadows.
Going into the Bedouin village for dinner tonight.
Inside the
we'll be right back.
Thank you. Sorry, Dad.